See students, in the previous class already we have solved exercise 4.3 by transposing method. Okay, we found out the value of the variable by transposing method. Now some more simple equations we are going to solve by the transposing method only, but not from the given equation. According to the given situation, we have to form the equation, then we have to solve them. That is applications of simple equations. Here just I solve one or two examples, then we can go for the exercise. Okay, first one example I'll just show you. The present situation of the life we convert into the equation. Those equations we'll solve. Okay, now the sum of the three times of a number, this is one very simple statement is there. One more we'll take. Raju's father's age is, this is situation problem. Raju's father's age is 5 years. More than three times Raju's age, find Raju's age. If his father is 44 years old, in your textbook it is worked example 10. You can see that one. See here, first we have to assume that the Raju's age be X or any one variable Y. Raju's father age is 5 years more than 3 times Raju's age. Here, let the Raju's age be X. Okay, then what they say? Raju's father's age is 5 years more than 3 times of Raju. Then the equation. What is the equation? Raju's father age is 5 years more than 3 times of Raju's age. That is 3x plus 5 years more. Then what is his father's present age? That is 44 years old. Now equation is ready. According to the given situation of the problem, first we write the equation. Now you know how to solve this by transposing method. 3x equal to 44 minus 5. When 5 comes to RHS, it will become minus. So 3x equal to 39. X equal to 39 by 3. So x equal to 13. X equal to 13. That means Raju's present age is 13 years old. Let the Raju's age be X enough. That means Raju is present 13 years old and his father is 44 years. This is what we have to solve the present situation, given situation. That is applications of simple equations. Okay, like this we have to solve the exercise. Exercise number 4. Now we solve exercise number 4. The first problem, we have to set up the equation first. See, set up equations and solve them to find unknown numbers in the following cases. First main, set up the equations and solve. You write the full heading. Since I am having the little place here, I couldn't write. So now the first one is add 4 to 8 times a number. 8 times a number, you get 60. You get
atom number, you get 60. See here, this implies that add 4 to 8 times a number. A number means what? Let a number be. Let a number be y. Okay. Then add 4 to 8 times of a number. Then equation. What is the equation? 8 times a number. A number is y. 8 times means 8y. Add 4. We have to add for that 4 to get 60. Now you know how to solve the equation. So this implies that 8y is equal to 60 plus minus 4. 60 minus 4. That is 8y is equal to 56. Y is equal to 56 by 8. So y is equal to 8 ones are 7. Therefore, y is equal to 8. Why we assume here? Let a number be y. That is, let a number is 7. This is what setting up the equation. This already we set up the equation and solve it. This is the method of doing the equations. Next, B1. B, 1/5 of a number minus 4 gives 3. See, this implies that let a number be x. Let a number be x. 1/5 of a number, that means 1 by 5 of that number minus 4 gives 3. So this implies that x by 5 is equal to 3 plus 4. This 4 will go that side. So what happens? X by 5 is equal to 10. So x is equal to, this 5 is multiplication when it goes up into 5. So therefore x is equal to 50 is the answer. So this is what method of solving the equations. Setting up and solving the equations. Okay. 7 plus 3, 10. Here, 5 times are 50. I hope you understood. Then next, in the same way, the third one. Minus is there. Huh? Minus 4, x by 5. Minus 4, 1 minute. Wait. X by 5, minus 4, equal to 3. Correct. When it goes, this will become 3 is there, no? 3 plus 4. Okay, sorry. 3 plus 4. That is here 7. So here, that's what I got a doubt. So 7 into 5. Therefore, x is equal to 35 is the answer. Next, C1. If I take 3/4 of a number, if I take 3/4 of a number, 3/4 of a number and add 3 to it, and add 3 to it, I get 21. I get 21. Here see, if I take 3/4 of a number, let a number be any one variable you can take. Here x we have taken, here y we have taken, here any m we take. Let a number be m. Then I take 3/4 of a number. If I take 3/4 of a number and add 3 to it, that means this implies that 3/4 of m plus 3 is equal to 21. So this implies that 3/4 of m is equal to 21 minus 3. So 3/4 of m is equal to 18. See, just I continue here. See here, 3m is equal to 4 into 18. So m is equal to 4 into 18 by 3. 3 ones are 3, 6 are 6, 4 are 24. Therefore, m is equal to 24. That means that number what we assumed is 24 is the answer. The same way, the problem D. When I subtracted 11 from twice a number, the result was 15. The result was 15. When I subtracted 11 from twice a number, here we have to assume one number. What is that? Let a number be. N. We'll take any one number. N. When I subtracted 11 from twice of a number, that implies that 2x subtracted 11, okay, was 15. So this implies that 2x is equal to 15 plus 11. So 2x is equal to, this is 26. X is equal to 26 by 2. Therefore, x is equal to 2 and 2 13s are 13. X equal to 13. This is what the fourth problem in the first main. The same way, fifth problem. Mudna subtracts thrice the number. Thrice the number of notebooks he has from from 50. He is having 50 notebooks. He subtracts thrice the number. He finds the result to be 8. He finds the result to be 8. Solution. Let the number be number we have taken is n, so 2n here also 2n. Always we are taking x, no? That will be there in the mind. So let the number be x. Munna subtracts thrice the number of notebooks he has from 50. So this implies that 50 minus 3x is equal to 8. Now 3x will take this, and this is minus, now it will become plus. So 50 minus 8 is equal to 3x. 50 minus 8 is 42 is equal to 3x. Therefore 42 by 3 is equal to x. 3 ones are 3 14s are. Therefore 14 is equal to x, or x is equal to 14. So this is the problem of first main fifth one. Next, sixth one, F. I hope you copied this. F one. Debate how things. Even half things of a number if she adds 19 to it, and divides the sum by divides the sum by 5, she will get 8. So first, what we have to assume? Let the number be x. Then what will be the things of a number? If she adds 19, that is x plus 19 to it, and divides the sum by 5. She will get 8. Now we have to solve this. X plus 19 is equal to 8 into 5. So x plus 19 is equal to 40. Therefore x is equal to 40 minus 19. 19 we have to take aside. Therefore x is equal to 21 is the answer. So this is the problem F. The same way G1, I hope you copied this. G, unknown things of a number. If he takes away, seven from five by two of the number, the result is 23. So first, unworth things of a number. So that number we have, what we have to assume? Let a number be x, or any other alphabet you can take. Be x. If he takes away 7 from 5 by 2 of the number. So this implies that 5 by 2 of that number takes away minus, that is 7. We have to get the result 23. So this implies that 5x by 2 is equal to 23 plus 7. 5x by 2 is equal to 30. 5x is equal to 2 into 30. 2 goes up. So 5x is equal to 60. x is equal to 60 by 5. Therefore, x is equal to 5 ones are 5, 12 are 12 is the answer. The number we assumed is 12.
This is wanted. The first main. The second main. Solve the following. CA students,
questions are very big. That's what? You take the questions from the textbook. Now I am going to solve the equation.
Here what we have to do? The teacher tells the class that the highest marks obtained by a student in her class is twice the lowest marks. Plus 7.
We don't know lowest marks. Twice the lowest marks. We have to assume the lowest marks as x
or any variable. The highest score is 87. What is the lowest score?
Okay. First what we have to assume? Let the score of lowest marks in the class be x.
Okay. Then the teacher tells the class that the highest marks obtained by a student in her class is twice the lowest marks plus 7.
This implies that twice the, that means twice the lowest marks plus 7 is equal to, what is the lowest, the highest score? 87. Now, therefore, 2x is equal to 87 minus 7. 2x is equal to 80. X is equal to 80 by 2. Therefore, x is equal to 2 ones are 2, 40 is a. The lowest marks is 40. Okay,
this is the first sum. Next, B. In an isosceles triangle, you know what is isosceles triangle?
This is isosceles triangle.
In an isosceles triangle, the base angles are equal. The vertex angle is 40. What are the base angles of the triangle?
See here, A, B, C. Here, these are the base angles and this is 40 degree. Let the base angles be, x. Then, in the triangle, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. So 40 plus X is equal to 180 degree. 40 plus 2X is equal to 180 degree. Here 2X is equal to 180 minus 40. So 2X is equal to 140 degree. X is equal to 140 by 2. So, therefore, X is equal to 2 ones are 270 is 70 degree. So, each angle, the base angle is 70 degree and 70 degree. This is what the second problem. Next.
See, Sachin scored twice as many runs as Rahul. Together their runs fell too short of a double century. How many runs did each one score? Okay. Sachin scored twice as Rahul's score. Let the Rahul's score be X.
Let the Rahul's score B X.
Then what is the Sachin score?
Then Sachin's score.
Sachin's score is 2
therefore equation. What is the equation? Together x plus 2x is equal to.
Together how much runs fell too short of a
double century. 200 double century. Too short means minus 2. So therefore x plus 2x is equal to 198. Therefore 3x is equal to 198. X is equal to 198 by 3. Therefore x is equal to 366. X equal to 66. This is what? Whose? Rahul's score. Therefore Rahul's score x is equal to 66 runs. Then Sachin's score is equal to 2x is equal to 2 into 66 is equal to 132 runs. Yes. This is what the method of
solving the problems. The same way now, even the third main also.
Very simple. Problems are simple. You have to practice more. Now the third main, take from the textbook.
Irfan says that he has 7 marbles more than 5 times the marbles Parmit has. Irfan has 37 marbles. How many marbles does Parmit have? Irfan is saying that he is having 37 marbles. But how he is saying? I am having 7 more marbles than the Parmit has.
We don't know Parmit's number. Therefore, that is third main.
First one, let the number of marbles Parmit has be x.
Let the number of marbles Parmit has be x. Then the equation.
Then the equation. What is the equation now? 5 times the marble. 7 marbles more.
That means 5x plus 7 is equal to
how much the Irfan is having?
37. So therefore 5x is equal to 37 minus 7. 5x equal to 30. Therefore, x is equal to 30 by 5. 5 ones are 5, 6 are. Therefore, x is equal to 6.
Okay, the number of Parmit has 6 marbles.
Then, the next one is
second one. Lakshmi's father is 49 years old.
Now, Lakshmi's father is 49 years old.
How he is 4 years older than 3 times Lakshmi's age. What is Lakshmi's age?
Let the Lakshmi's age be x. Then equation.
What is the equation? Lakshmi's father is 49 years old. He is 4 years older than 3 times of Lakshmi's age. 3x plus older means plus 4 is equal to 49. 4 years, no? Yes, 4 years older than 3 times. 3 times 4 years older. Then Lakshmi's father's age is 49. Okay.
3x is equal to 49 minus 4. 3x is equal to 45. X is equal to 45 by 3. Therefore, x is equal to 3 ones are 315. So, x equal to 15. That means what is that 15? Therefore, the present age of Lakshmi is, the present age of Lakshmi is equal to 15 years. So this is what the second problem in the third main. Next, the third one.
People of Sundargram planted trees in the village garden.
In one village, people planted the trees.
Some of the trees were fruit trees.
In that some way, fruit trees.
The number of non-fruit trees were 2 more than 3 times the number of fruit trees. How much they are? The number of non-fruit. Some are fruit. Some are non-fruit. The number of non-fruit, how they are? Non-fruit trees were 2 more than 3 times the number of fruit trees. What was the number of fruit trees planted? If the number of non-fruit trees planted was 77,
let the number of fruit trees be x. Then equation,
what is the equation? The number of non-fruit trees were 2 more than
3 times 3x plus 2 is equal to total number of trees 77. So 3x is equal to 77 minus 2. 3x is equal to 75. X is equal to 75 by 3. Therefore, X is equal to 3 ones are 3, 25 is 25. What is the X here? Number of fruit trees. Therefore, number of fruit trees, X is equal to 25 trees. Then how many non-fruit? Therefore, number of non-fruit trees is equal to total number 77 minus 25 is equal to 52 trees are non-fruit trees.
So, this is what the third way. The last way
here only I do.
Very simple it is, like riddle.
Fourth one is riddle. I am a number, that we have to assume it as x. I am a number. What we have to assume? That is x.
Okay. Then tell my identity.
What is this identity? It is a variable. Tell my identity. Identity. What is this? This is variable.
Okay. Next. Take me 7 times
over. Take me 7 times over. 7 times over. That means it is 7x.
Okay. Add 50.
And 50, F-I-F-T-Y, like that they have given 50. It is simple as that. 7x plus 50.
Okay. Then to reach a triple century, you still need 40.
To reach triple century. Century,
you still need 40.
That means that 7x plus 50 is equal to 300 minus 40.
7x plus to reach triple century.
Yes, 300 minus 40. So this implies that 7x plus 50 is equal to 260. So 7x is equal to 260 minus 50. So 7x is equal to 210. X is equal to 210 by 7. 7 ones are 7 30s are. So x is equal to 30.
X is equal to 30 is the answer. This is what exercise 4.4.
Now homework I am going to give you. What is the homework? Homework I give you. Exercise 4.4 is the exercise. Daily you have to solve the exercise whichever I am doing here. Okay. This is what exercise 4.4 and also this completes this chapter. Now what you have to do? After this 4.4, just turn the page, you will get what have we discussed. These points are there. These all points you have to write one by one as the points. You know how the points will be written. Either like this one by one or like this star. Okay, one by one go on writing neatly in your fair book. By this chapter completes already. Today we have sent you the timetable of the FA1. So please be prepared. Chapter 1 and 2 are there in that. Be prepared. Go on solving all the sums. Become perfect. Okay. Thank you for watching. Share and subscribe my channel.